Okay, so I know that it's February, but I thought I would share with you the books that I wanted to get to this year. I'm gonna put them in categories of books that are on my shelf, books that are being adapted into movies or TV this year that I want to get to, and anticipated new releases of 2018. Now, when it comes to a physical TBR, I don't actually have that much. I'm pretty good with reading books as soon as I buy them. Also, I don't buy books in bulk. I kind of buy them one by one. That's just the way I've been doing it, and I like doing it that way because then I don't feel claustrophobic in my room. So I only have three unread books on my shelf. So the first one, and the oldest one that's been on my shelf for a really long time, is Vicious by V.E. Schwab. The second book is another gift that I got from my brother 2 years ago, I think. It's 1984 by George Orwell. And the third unread book on my shelf I only got a month ago, and that is Sense and Sensibility by Jane Austen. This is the very first Jane Austen book that I want to get to because I do really like the movie adaptation of this, the one with Alan Rickman in it. And also, I actually bought this book from Shakespeare and Company in Paris, and so I'm never going to get rid of this book. So I hope I enjoy it. Also, I've never read a Jane Austen book, so I thought I would start. Moving on to movies that are being adapted to movies or TV. The first one I have on the list is actually the Shatter Me series by Tahereh Mafi. I've heard really great things about her writing style. I know that it's very kind of 2013 YA tropey type stuff, but I've heard her writing style is really good. I've also heard, although it's a dystopian, it doesn't do a lot of world building, and I know that's a lot of people's complaints about that series, but I actually get bored with world building. I like characters, and so hearing that there's not a lot of world building in the series kind of makes me want to pick it up. Also, it's turning into a TV show. The next one I have is A Wrinkle in Time by an author that I can't remember the name of, but it's a children's classic. I'm sure that everyone and their mother has read this book, but the movie comes out on March 9th. The third one I have on the list is Between Shades of Grey, which is a historical fiction that has been super hyped, and I really want to get to it because there's a movie coming out. And the last one I have on the list for this category is Pet Sematary by Stephen King. I know I keep saying that I'm giving up on Stephen King, but Pet Sematary was actually one of the first books that I did want to get to, and it's the one that I haven't gotten to because it's about zombies, and I'm just in the mood for like some cheesy zombie horror fun. And apparently it's been picked up. I'm not sure if the movie's coming out this year or 2019, but yeah, I want to read that book anyway. And if a new adaptation of the movie comes out, then that'll be a bonus. And the last category I have are anticipated book releases of 2018. So I'm not going to give you guys the synopsis, I'll just put the links to the Goodreads pages down in the description bar below. The first one actually already came out, and that is Let's Talk About Love by Claire Kahn. It came out on January 23rd, and I think this is about a girl who has a breakup over the summer because she's asexual or something, and then stuff happens over the summer. I don't really know what it's about, but it's contemporary, and it's cute, and it's diversity. Next, we have What the Night Sings by Vesper Stamper. That's a cool name. It's a historical fiction, and apparently it's for fans of The Book Thief. So it's basically about this girl who survives or escapes the concentration camps, and she basically lost all her family and her music and just everything she had. And I think it's about her refinding herself, or it's about like a coming of age, or like building a new future or something like that. It sounds very character driven, and it's also historical fiction, World War II, and you all know I love World War II books, so I'm definitely anticipating this one to come out. Oh, actually, it already came out. It came out on the 20th of February, so a couple of days ago. Next, we have Blood, Water, Paint by Joy McCullough something. I can't pronounce that name. I'm so sorry. This is apparently based on a true story about a painter. It's historical fiction. She does a lot of these paintings for her community or something, but no one knows that she's the one doing them. And then one day, she gets assaulted or she gets raped, and I think it's about her trying to be heard or find a voice or something like that. It sounds really interesting. And that comes out on the 6th of March. The next one I have on the list is To Kill a Kingdom by Alexandra Christo. I heard about this book from the Book Brats. They said that it's kind of a retelling of The Little Mermaid, but the mermaid wants to kill the human or something, and I'm always up for retelling, so I put that on the list. That book comes out on March 6th as well. The next one I have on the list to come out is On the Come Up by Angie Thomas. This one seems really cool. So it's about this daughter of a legendary rapper who wants to get into the music industry and wants to rap as well, but stuff happens in her life, and it's about her choosing the more important stuff of life and like her family and all that stuff, or her music and her dreams. And it sounds really awesome. Also, it's by Angie Thomas. I haven't read The Hate U Give, but I've heard so many great things about that book. It's coming out on June 5th. The second last one I have on the list is My Plain Jane by Cynthia Hand, Jodie Meadows, and Brodie Ashton. This is apparently a retelling of Jane Eyre, and I really like Jane Eyre, and I'm definitely down for a retelling. So that book comes out on June 26th. And the last book I have on the list is The Game of Hope by Sandra Gullen. This is set in Paris around the time of the French Revolution, and it tells the story of Napoleon Bonaparte's stepdaughter. It seems really cool, and also it's set in Paris, and also it's historical fiction, so I'm definitely down for that. It comes out on June 26th as well. So those are the books that I'm trying to get to this year. I'm trying to be really good in reading new releases, because I seem to read a lot of older books, and that's great. I still want to do that, but I do want to make an effort to read more new releases. Yeah, let me know if you're also anticipating some of those new releases, and if you have any other contemporary books or historical fiction books that you think I might like that you want to suggest to me down in the comments below, please do so. And I hope you're having a great day, and I will see you soon.